Very bizarre story here. Bizarre. Literally insane. And I don't understand this story at all. Here's a son of a man that was missing for 60 years. And all of a sudden, a disappearance of his father. George Carroll mysteriously disappeared in 61. And Long Island man believes that he found his missing father's bones in his own basement. Now, the story as it goes, after all this time and the suspicion looking and trying to locate him after nearly 60 years, the family can now rest to assure that we can give him a proper burial and memorial. They're still investigating the story to see if this is even the bones of this man. But what is very bizarre and totally fucking insane is that they were told some stories when they were younger. And Long Island man was not entirely surprised when he found human bones buried in the basement of his home. After a six decade search, he believes that those bones belong to his own father. So he's not surprised. And when you go down here, you know, they purchased the home in 1957. But get this. And his wife, Dorothy, purchased the home in which his alleged remains were just found in 1957. Now that there's messed up. Alleged remains were found in 1957. They lived there with Michael, now 57, and his three older siblings. Michael explained that the missing person report was never filed. But yet, Michael's mother allegedly told him and his siblings that their father had gone out to do something and simply never returned. All of the children were under 10 years old at the time of their father's disappearance. As we grew up, we heard multiple stories. Michael said he and his three siblings were reportedly told not to ask too many questions about what really happened to their father. They believed it was for their own protection. Now, I don't get this at all. I mean, it goes on to saying that the mother passed away in the late 90s. Michael inherited the home. Did his own excavation of the basement. Nearly damaged the house, blah, blah, blah. But doing it outside, digging that he brought someone in, led to them using a penetrating radar. Now this thing here, I tried asking someone to find Tajna bone with, and it does detect dark, like dark shadows in the ground, but it's not good for a lot of other reasons. It's for, you know, 3 feet, maybe 4 feet deep. It only shows like blackness if something is there. Wish I'd like to get one of these radars to even try it, but of course it goes on to say it would be nice to get one of them. But to a possible area of interest in the basement. So these people pretty much kind of knew something, but were told not to ask about it. And yet, digging for months until they finally made a discovery they'd been hoping for. The bones were found 6 feet below, surrounded by cement walls. the fuck? Now, back in the day, yes. And they still do it in some places. People used to be buried 6 feet. Why this man was put 6 feet in a basement and not... And they go on to say, doing DNA testing to see if it is the father. It'd be really fucked up if it ain't the father. But all this time of suspicion, looking and trying to locate him after nearly 60 feet. Oh, they can give him a proper burial and memorial. Who the fuck gives up looking for their father? And not, I mean, come on. Something the mother knew, something had happened, and this man was buried 6 feet in the ground, 60 fucking years, and nobody knows what happened. Things that make you say, I hope there's a lot more to this story when it comes up, but I had to share this one because this is just out of league. Something like this should have been looked into a long time ago. And kids go on to not care about where their father went. You know, the fucking wife could have killed him. Someone could have killed him, put him down there. Or maybe this guy was doing some crazy fucking shit. Who knows? Whatever the case may be. I like to know why this man spent 60 years of not being located, found, or nothing. No missing report. And unless he got buried or killed himself because maybe he was in the mafia. I don't know. I know I'm very curious, and if I was a son of a father that was missing for 60 years, I'd like to know the truth. And of course, probably the only person that knew about it was the mother, is dead. Whatever the case may be, I hope the examiner comes up with some kind of report on this. But I thought I'd share this because this is just one sick, bizarre story. Just fucking weird. And for them to just, you know, and this guy just to say, oh, we can give us to show him peace now and a proper burial. I was like, guy, you don't want to know why your father was 60 years in a fucking basement behind walls 6 feet deep? Yeah, something wrong there. Something wrong there. But anyways, I got to keep up on this one, see what happens. If anybody else want to keep up with me, if I get any information before me, let me know. But here's the name of the video, and I mean video ad, and it is, if anybody wants to, all that's interesting is these articles come up with some good stuff. Some are stupid, some are damn good, and this one, wow, unbelievable. Till the next video, be safe, take care, and beware. You'll never know where you'll end up. In a basement, buried 6 feet behind some walls. Who the fuck knows? This is crazy. Out.